Hi, third graders, it's Mrs. Mangan here, and today we're going to have some fun with some poetry centers. You've been doing a wonderful job building your repertoire of poetic devices and poetic tools. We've so enjoyed reading your poetry and seeing how you're using repetition. How are you using rhyme? What kind of onomatopoeia are you adding? It has been really fun for us, so keep up the good work and enjoy the kind of different pace of today. Now, I'm going to introduce two different centers to you. One choice is to just do one of them. The other choice is to try both. But as long as you're doing at least one, that's good with us. I want to remind you of the online poetry resources that we've been making available to you on our blogs. Please make sure you're visiting these websites. I think you're going to enjoy seeing poetry written by adults and children, and you can find some inspiration for your own poems there. We've also added like a playlist, like a collection of poetry in your Epic like profiles. So make sure when you go in and you see that little mailbox in the upper right-hand corner, you're going to see that one of the collections that's made available to you is a poetry. So see if you can read those books as well. So let's get to the centers. And the first center is an art center. So we're going to be reading poetry that's already been written and get inspiration for a drawing. So here's what you're going to do. You're going to read several poems, either from books or from those online resources that I just listed. Then I want you to choose one poem that really creates a strong image in your mind. And throughout these weeks, we've been talking about imagery and how poems can make you have a picture or a smell or a feeling in your mind. So find one poem that makes that strong image in your mind. Then copy that poem into your poetry notebook or onto the paper that you've been using. And then I want you to illustrate that. Find a way for you to show what that poem looks like to you. And if you can't just pick one image, go ahead, pick three, pick four, create a collage, create kind of like a web. Whatever you see from that poem, we want you to create. And when you're done, please put your picture on Seesaw and read the poem out loud to us so that we can see what you've created and what you've imagined from that poem. The next one is a discovery center. This is for all of you who are wanting to get outside and explore and be inspired by nature. So go outside, go on a nature hunt in your neighborhood or your front or your backyard and bring something with you like a bucket or a basket. And I want you to collect things that you find along the way, pine cones, rocks, twigs, leaves, whatever you see. And at the end of your little walk, find one item that really inspires you. Take it to a quiet place and start sketching it. Draw some pictures of it in using notebook or with a paper you have. And when you're done sketching, think about what you notice along the way. What does this item look like? What does it remind you of? What are some questions you have about it? In your notebook, divide a piece of paper into four boxes using these headings and describe it. Describe what it looks like. Compare it to something else, describe what it feels like, and list three questions about the object. So see what I've done here. When you've done describing your object, create a poem from your notes. And I've done one myself. So I found the lilac tree in my backyard that has a bunch of little hard buds on it, just waiting to come into its own and to bloom into the beautiful purple lilac. Now, I was inspired by this. I loved the look of it. I loved the feel of it. And I loved wondering when it was going to come and bloom. So here's my observation poem inspired by that lilac bud. Lilac buds, hard and green, leaves like rosebuds tucked in tightly, smooth to the touch, waiting to be more. When will you arrive? Your pretty violet flowers, I can't wait for you to bloom. So for your observation poem, please take a picture of the object that inspired you and read us your poem on Seesaw. Now you have one of those two choices, whether you're inspired to draw art from a poem you've already seen, or if something from nature inspires you to write poetry. You have one of those two choices today. As long as you're doing one and you're showing us on Seesaw, we are excited to see what you do, and we can't wait to read more of your poems. Good luck, poets, and have some fun today.